For anyone who's been watching my channel for a while, you know Andrew Rivers. He's one of my favorite comedians to tour with, and now he has a brand new comedy special.
It's 25 minutes of COVID jokes recorded in a comedy club that seats 300 people, but there was 80 people spaced out due to COVID regulations.
How'd you handle playing all those people?
It's a lot more than I'm used to, but we made it through.
Hopefully he wasn't too nervous.
No, very nervous.
All right, enjoy the thing.
I think Gallagher would be the perfect comedian to be on tour during coronavirus, you know, because the audience already has a sheet above them, so it'll work out really well, you know. He was ahead of his time. Glad to be in Oklahoma. People ask me why I'm on tour during a pandemic. I don't have a great answer for it, but, you know, comedy's a weird business. You're gonna do crazy things. Try to get ahead. I read a story about Jim Carrey. Like, early on in his career, he wrote himself a $1 million check and then post-dated it for, like, years in the future. And then when the day came around, he was able to cash a check for himself for $1 million as, like, motivation. And I've done a similar thing. It's just called credit cards. You just buy whatever you want. Every time I'm like, money doesn't exist. It's fine. I live in Seattle, and I'm kind of a libtard, but I'm glad that Oklahoma is a red state, because I need places to perform. So it's like this very, I'm like, we need each other. There's unity possible, you know, if we can just agree. Comedy's illegal in Seattle. All the comedy clubs are shut down, but I'm hoping this will make me sound more interesting on first dates. If a girl is like, what do you do for work? I'm like, what do I do for work? Well, we probably shouldn't talk about it here. Kind of illegal. She's like, oh, so mysterious. Am I dating Batman? Yeah, I am exactly like Batman. If Batman took his parents' money and started a podcast, we are the same. Exactly the same. I don't know. Some of the lockdowns don't make sense to me. Like bars are closed, but schools are allowed to open. That doesn't make sense. Bars are way safer than schools. At least bars kick people out after they vomit on the floor. In kindergarten, that's called finger painting, you know? It's so easy to do contact tracing at bars. Everyone is wearing an ankle monitor already, you know? But I think schools are very prepared for coronavirus, you know? If a kid gets sick and dies, they already have plenty of chalk to outline the body, so that's gonna be fun. Oh, come on, that's... Kids are mostly immune or whatever, I don't know. It's fine. It's just a hypothetical dead baby joke. It's not real. I don't know, man. It's weird. Coronavirus is crazy. Especially because the symptoms are so vague, you know? Like, you know, they're like, oh, diarrhea and headache and you're tired. It's like, okay, well, do I have coronavirus or is that the Chipotle I had for lunch? I don't know. Let's be more specific. It's weird how we can't agree on any part of the virus, you know? Like, we can't agree if it's real, we can't agree how bad it is. It feels like if Godzilla was ever attacking a town, there'd be a bunch of people like, it's cause of the election, wash! It's gonna go away in November, Godzilla doesn't like the heat. And you're like, what is that? Then you log on to Twitter and Trump is like, call it where it came from, the China lizard. And you're like, all right, that's... It's Japan, you're racist twice, but Well, I know a lot of people don't like Trump jokes, and I don't like them either. Every time his press conferences come on, I'm like, don't do it, man. You're a good comedian. You don't need him. And then I just find myself at rock bottom again. Come on, man, just give me one more. Give me a Clorox remix or something, you know? My favorite was the dementia test, right? He passed that dementia test and then he bragged about it like 8 times. I was like, did he forget he already bragged about it? I think he has dementia. That's gotta be a sign that you have dementia. I feel like the general's gotta be so mad at him, right? He's on TV every day going, person, woman, man, camera, TV. And they're like, fuck, we gotta change the nuclear codes again. You know, this is ridiculous. I don't know, they say liberals won't be nice to Trump, but you know, when he was in the hospital, I went to a candlelight vigil for him that was mostly Democrats. We were burning down a Wendy's, but it's the thought that counts, you know? It's just, you know, you show your love in the way that you know how. Oh, man. I read that dogs can detect coronavirus just by smelling the urine of an infected person, which is why whenever I see a dog at the airport, I just piss myself, because I have weed on me. I'm like, smell this instead, don't get me. That's crazy that you can detect it just by smelling a person. That means if you want a free COVID test, you just have to stand next to Joe Biden. And he's a sniffer. I like to make both sides uncomfortable in the show, just to let you know. Some states are locking back down again. Crazy. Hope that doesn't happen for me, but I don't really care. I wasn't allowed near public parks before any of this happened, so not too different. But, you know, I thought with all this extra time on my hands, it's a perfect opportunity to reach out to some friends I haven't talked to in a while. So I called this girl from high school who was like, not even if we were the last people on Earth. Like, hey, did you read the news? It's almost time. Call me. I believe her exact quote was, call me when cars are abandoned on I-5. And I was like, all right, I appreciate your subtlety. And then protests started blocking traffic. I was like, remember me? Hey! It feels like the end of the world sometimes. It's not. We're going to be fine. But it just feels like protests every night. You know, it's crazy. I saw one sign at a protest that said, racism is the worst virus. I was like, oh, that's a good one. I think racism and coronavirus have a lot in common. You know, like some of us only have a little bit of it. You know, you can give it to other people without knowing it, and your grandma will probably die with it. It's all right. And they're both going away after the election, you know, so that's fine. See, this is scary. I don't know. If you guys are like, oh, we agree, or you're like, excellent joke, or... I'm not going to ask the answer, but, you know, I'm not out there protesting. I wish I was. I just have a pre-existing condition. I'm a giant pussy, and it's really getting in the way of everything I want to do. But I'm doing my part from home. I'm typing my Facebook statuses in all caps. That way people know I mean business. I like having discussions on Facebook. It's hard because it always turns into an argument. I was chatting with a guy recently and I asked him for proof of his claim. He sent me to a website called freedomfiction.com. I'm like, wow, freedom fiction? I mean, the name seems suspicious, but the logo's a bald eagle with an AR-15. Who can you trust anymore? I get it. I'm not mad at them. It's hard to find reliable news coverage right now because they keep tear gassing the reporters, but every day is a new story. Huh? Wear a mask. Don't wear a mask. Wear a mask again, you know? Trump said he's not going to wear a mask, but instead he'll stay 6 feet away from any responsibility. So that's good. I wrote that before he got it, and I was like, I'm a genius. And called it. I try to wear the mask all the time, but I forget sometimes. I walked into a Whole Foods recently and I forgot my mask. Holy shit, those people let me have it. That's the scariest experience of my life. I'm just minding my own business. They're like following me around and filming me. One Karen in the corner, call the police, it's gonna kill everybody. I was like, wow, I think I accidentally discovered what it's like to be black in America. So that's really- The black guy's laughing, so I hope you guys know. Isn't that white people get so, oh, are we allowed? Is that? It's a good joke. Anyway, fake news is out there though, and it's tough. You gotta be on your toes there. But I got two tips for you, just to remember as you navigate the fake news world, okay? Rule number one, always keep an open mind. Obviously. And number two, Jeffrey Epstein didn't kill himself. All right, those are just facts. Yeah. Goddamn right. You want to argue opinions? We can argue opinions, but those are facts. So back the fuck off, man. I love conspiracy theories. I saw a guy at an airport one time. He had a t-shirt on and said 9/11 was an inside job. I was like, why would you wear that shirt in an airport? It feels like you're asking for extra attention at that point. You know what else is an inside job? Cavity searches. Poop jokes. Come on, guys. Get on board. I did read one study that says CBD might help with immunity to coronavirus. It's just my study. Just been smoking a bunch of weed. But I feel great, so there's probably something to that. I did learn you can overdose on marijuana. Do you guys know that? It's not lethal. You're not going to die. But like the other night, a helicopter flew so low it shook my entire house. I was like, they're probably dropping chemicals on us. And then I was like, oh, that's too much pot. I hit the limit. Look, don't get mad at me. Marijuana is an essential business. I'm just trying to keep this goddamn economy afloat by myself. Just me and toilet paper. That's just that's how we keep America running. It was crazy. People were hoarding groceries. At first, that was insane. I had plenty of toilet paper, thankfully, but my grocery store ran out of almond milk, which was tough. Yeah, because regular milk causes me to use too much toilet paper. Boom, two poop jokes. Come on, guys, you don't deserve me. Come on, come on. All I do is give. One nice thing about being forced to quarantine was that I didn't have to lie to my parents about what I did during the day anymore. Yeah. They just call me up. How was your day? Pretty good. What'd you do? Fucking nothing. I just sat around, wrote some jokes. I didn't even leave the house. They're like, we're so proud of you. You're keeping us alive, you know. Because they're old. That's the joke. I don't know. I just tried to keep a routine during lockdown. That way I didn't go crazy, you know. Just treat every day like it's a normal day. And like even before bed, I'd set an alarm. And then first thing in the morning, I wake up, I take the gun out of my mouth, I brush my teeth, you know. I just try to keep everything. Don't, it's not a sad joke, it's just fun. My dad is worried about me, but I'm just smoking weed and watching Netflix, I promise. This is all I've ever wanted out of life. And I love Netflix, but it's too hard to pick out a movie on Netflix. The categories suck. I'll spend more time picking out a movie than the length of the movie that I wasn't sure if I should watch. Because you gotta pick the right movie for the right situation, you know? I was Netflix and chilling with a girl one time. She picked out too good of a movie. So like halfway through, she started to make her move. I had to be like, hey, get off of me. This is an important plot point. There's subtitles, babe. I gotta pay attention. This won an Oscar. Gotta pick the right movie for the right situation. We need better Netflix categories. We need to categorize movies on Netflix by how much attention you have to pay to the plot in order to follow along, right? You wanna know what you're getting into. You wanna know what you're investing, right? Bottom tier is like Fast and Furious movies, right? Oh, Fast and Furious is on. Let me go get my taxes. I can do that at the same time. Right? Every 15 minutes you look up and, oh, Vin Diesel's winning. That's fine, I guess. I don't know. Oh, he's angry. That's bad. All right. Oh, it's good again. Other end of the spectrum, Game of Thrones. Game of Thrones is on. Let's go to the storage unit and get my notes. I got 17 pages of notes from the previous episode. You know? I got a map for my fake TV show that we got to study. I don't know my own city in real life this well, but I got a map with a history. I need an Ancestry.com account just to understand what the... These are their brother and sister. This show is very weird. A couple people remember. Lots of incest in that show, but I don't know. We need more realistic Netflix categories. How about a Netflix category that's like, hey, we actually analyzed the movies you liked, and here's some dope shit you haven't seen yet, you know? Or like, hey, here's a movie your friend was telling you about the other day. We were listening on your phone, even though you weren't using it. Don't worry, we'll show you an Instagram ad later and remind you. Like, do a lot of Zoom comedy still, which is pretty awful. Doing comedy on Zoom, that's gotta be what alcoholics feel like every time they drink in O'Doul's. That is not even close to good, but the other thing might kill me. So, alright, note to self, don't remind the audience they might die tonight. That's good. Always works out for shows, but it's crazy how we moved online for a couple months, you know? I got invited to a Zoom sex orgy. Yeah, I mean, I'm not trying to brag, but it's the first orgy I've ever been invited to, but I still have to do all the work. That doesn't seem like fun. That defeats the whole purpose. I've only got two hands. I'll let you guys guess where the others go, but I don't think Zoom's the right app for an orgy. Sometimes the connection is slow and the screen is all fuzzy. Reminds me when I was 13 trying to watch porn on a channel my parents wouldn't pay for, you know, like, oh, if you squint, you can make out a boob, that's pretty hot, you know? Plus, there's like 13 different squares, I can't focus on that. Feels like I'm jerking off to the Brady Bunch intro, you know? It's like, oh, Alice. Love a woman that knows her way around the kitchen. Trying to get laid in real life, and it's tough. I was thinking about joining Tinder, but then I was like, they got enough diseases on there as it is. So I downloaded Farmers Only. You know what I mean? I was like, ah, they're way out in the country. The virus hasn't even got there yet. It's gonna be fine. My profile was like, my turn-ons include a 6-month supply of food and extra toilet paper. And every time I matched with a girl, I'd be like, hey, wanna compare eggplants? No preservatives on mine. Right, you guys need to spice up your sexting conversations. I don't know what's wrong with you that you don't get the joke, but I don't like dating apps in general because I don't have like a swipeable face. You know what I mean? Like no one looks at me from across the room and goes, "That's exactly what I want." You know, takes convincing. Yeah. Convincing. plus, I get too invested in the app. Like, I'll spend like 6 hours looking at the profile and imagining our life together, and then she just doesn't respond. And I'm like, oh no, it was gonna be so great. Sometimes I get butthurt when I find out an old Tinder match has unfollowed me on Instagram. And I get it, like, things didn't work out, but I'm still a really funny comedian. Like, you should still follow me. I was flirting with this nurse gal for a couple months. It was pretty hot. I've always had a fetish for that kind of thing. They employ women. And you got a stable paycheck? What's that like? Things didn't work out. The pandemic was really getting in the way of our sexy nurse role-playing we used to do, you know? At first it was like sexy, you know, low cleavage and red lipstick. Now it's like nice face covering, baby. That's so hot. Your PPE is a garbage bag? Ooh, you were steaming up my shield. But I don't need her anymore. I found someone else to pay my bills for me. His name was Governor Jay Inslee from Washington State. Yeah, I was on unemployment for a couple months, which is pretty humbling when the government is like, hey, we'll pay you to not tell jokes. I thought it was going pretty well. I don't know. The unemployment was great. Honestly, if we could go back to that, it was amazing. I was with the bonuses, I was getting like 80% of my normal salary as a comedian. But now I didn't have to pay for plane tickets or hotels or sex. I was saving so much money. It was insane. They still owe me a month worth of money, too, because they got hacked. The state of Washington got hacked, and they lost like $300 million, which is crazy. Because now, when I get an email from a Nigerian prince, he might actually have my money. So, what am I supposed to do? Been enjoying the NBA. I enjoyed the NBA playoffs this year, but I didn't like that the players had social justice slogans on their jersey instead of their name. And I don't care about politics and sports or any of that. I just, I don't know the names of the players anymore. So I'm yelling at the TV like, oh, fuck you, Black Lives Matter, you know? You and education reform can suck my dick, you know? long story short, I'm not allowed at Buffalo Wild Wings anymore. So it's, I'm in the corner like, Minneapolis is on fire! They're like, please leave. We've had enough of you. Big sports fan. I read that Bud Light was offering the city of Detroit, everyone in the city of Detroit was going to get a free beer if the Lions kicker broke the record for longest field goal in a season. And I think the Lions should focus on only that all season. What are you going to win, 4 games? Come on, guys. Just fucking kick a field goal every time. I don't care if it's 75 yards. Kick a field. Imagine you make that free beer for everyone in the city. You're a legend forever. No one would ever tear down that statue. That's all I'm saying, right? This guy's a hero. In less than 20 years, they find out he said the N-word in his car while he's rapping along to 50 Cent, and then they're like, you're canceled. Get out of here. A lot of people are upset about the Confederate statues, and I have, you know, I see both sides of the issue, to be honest. On the one hand, like, the Confederacy lasted 4 years. That's not really heritage, that's a phase you went through in high school, you know? On the other hand, I had a girlfriend for 3 months that I still write jokes about 3 years later, so I get it, it's hard to get over stuff, you know? She keeps texting me going, give me back my underwear. I'm like, no, those are monuments to history. Comedy clubs were open in Seattle for 1 month, and I was so excited to perform comedy again, because this is what I love to do. This is all I do. It's all I think about, and it consumes my life. And so I was so happy to get to do comedy again, and then comedy clubs shut back down. That's when I learned depression comes in waves also. Just trying to figure out if this was a second wave or still part of the first wave. They've blended together, but I was talking to my buddy about it because he's been to lots of therapy and I can't afford it. Because I was really bummed out about not being able to tour and stuff. And he said I have a joy deficit, which is like the thing, you know, when the thing you love the most was taken away from you. And I was trying to be funny. I was like, oh, is that what it felt like when you got divorced? And he was like, no, that's what it felt like when I got married. And I was like, oh, okay. it's his joke. I mean, I made him say it, but I've been trying to replace the joy in my life, find new things that make me happy. So I discovered hiking while I was in lockdown, because I've never been a big hiker, but you know, what better for your depression than to be alone in the woods for several hours, you know? I was worried about bears, because I'm a pussy, and my friend was like, yeah, don't worry about it. They leave you alone most of the time. I was like, well, what about when it's not most of the time? And so I looked it up online, but it's very confusing because it says, oh, if it's a brown bear, do one thing, but if it's a black bear, do the complete opposite. And I'm like, well, that's fine, but how do I explain to the bear that I don't see color? You know, like that. My friend hit me up, and he's like, you're an idiot. And it turns out there's like a limerick, you can remember, there's like a nursery rhyme to remember if you see a bear. It goes, if it's brown, lay down. If it's black, fight back. I was like, I think he got that from LAPD, actually. But, you know, oh, well, if it's a polar bear, you say all lives matter, and then it's fine. I love that joke so much, but I have a little shirt for sale after the show. Careful with the loud coughing, buddy. It's kind of a thing going around. I mean, I'd rather fart in public than cough out loud. I don't know why. Even if I was coughing, I'd be like, no, I pooped. That was what that was. I just started a new diet. It's called intermittent fasting. I don't know if you guys know what that is. Basically, between the hours of 8 a.m. and 8 p.m., I can't afford to eat. So it's pretty good. Yeah. It started as one of those like Hollywood diets where they pretend to be poor, but I'm more of a method actor, so please buy a shirt.
If you enjoyed this, make sure to follow Steel City AF on all social media. And Andrew J. Rivers.
And Steve Hofstetter.
They're already here.
No, they're not.
All right, that's true.
We're going to unsubscribe after this.
Thanks for watching, everybody.
Really appreciate it.